for some reason, which I didn't know way back at the beginning of thinking of it, there was a cemetery, and he could see the cemetery outside his window. And originally it was going to be a Chicago cemetery that I know really well, and then I thought, what's the coolest cemetery anywhere? And that's Highgate. And so when I first got in touch with the people who run Highgate, I ended up talking to a woman named Jean Pateman, who's the chairman of the Friends of Highgate Cemetery. And I phoned up and I said, hi, I'm a novelist, I live in Chicago, and I want to write a novel that's about your cemetery. And she said, oh my dear, I don't think that would be a very good idea. But anyway, she let me come and see her, and eventually she came around to the idea, and then she enlisted me to be a guide at Highgate Cemetery, which has been thrilling. So it's it turned out to be great. You never know at the beginning of a project where you will end up with it. So the setting has turned out to be magical and has inspired a lot of crazy things in the book that I could never have thought of on my own. My interests, I've discovered, unbeknownst to me, seem to center around the idea of loss. And this had to be pointed out to me by someone who came to a presentation I was giving, and at the Q&A she put her hand up and she said, why is all of your work about loss? And I said, it is? What? And then I went home and thought about it and realized that, in fact, everything I do is about time passing, people dying. There's also a lot of people being born in my work, but a lot of it has to do with the idea that everything is transitory and we should make the most of what we've got. Usually when somebody says, what's your new novel about? I say, well, it's a ghost story and it's set in London. It's got to do with Highgate Cemetery. And people just kind of nod and go, uh-huh. But there's a lot of other things going on. It has to do with a pair of mirror image twins who have been raised in America in a posh suburb outside of Chicago. And they have an aunt that they've never met who suddenly dies and leaves them her flat. And it's a very beautiful, spacious flat that is right next to Highgate Cemetery. They have a wall that that they share. And so the twins very happily come to London to live in their new flat. And unbeknownst to them, their aunt is stuck in the flat. She's a ghost. And so she's happy to see them, but she can't really communicate with them. And the twins get entangled with their neighbors and cause a certain amount of havoc. Ultimately, the ghost is able to make herself known. And at that point, everything kind of slides into chaos.